Planning to start. And I'm giving a floor to our professor Striegel. Thank you for joining us tonight. So let's have a presentation of the course from Professor Striegel, and then we will have some feedbacks after all at the end.
Hello, my name is Professor Leanne Striegel, and it's nice to see some of you. I can see some of you. I can't, so I
Please,
don't.
guys, put your videos on. That will increase your level of participation. Your interaction will be more, let's say, productive.
Yes, I like to see you. So, although I do know sometimes people are connecting from. Maybe they didn't expect more of an interactive session, so maybe they're connecting from a phone or someplace that, or they're eating or something like that, which is fine. You can leave the video off, or if you're having sound problems, let us know so that, or if you turn the video on and you can't hear, then obviously that's not a big deal if you leave the video off for now. I just, for the most part, I'm going to. Show you some tools and do some fun things here. So hopefully it'll be interactive a little bit. And so for that, I need to know that you exist, that you can hear me, that you're there. And that's why the video is good. Forgive me if I ask those intrusive questions for those of you that don't have your video on. There is one person that will not have his video on, and he's in the center of my screen, Donald Cannon. He's another professor at Pericles, and he's just sitting in, hanging out with us tonight. So he teaches a different class called Approaching Legal English. And just wanted to
Also, we have a few people here who are happen to be our students at the courses of Legal English, Approaching Legal English. I see familiar faces. Plus, we've got even LLM alumni, Christina Gantirova, one of our graduates. So I'm happy to see you all here.
Yes.
Hi, Shakshuk. I'm sorry I don't have an opportunity to participate with video, and I'm very happy to be here. And I've also invited some of my students, and I'm
Thank
seeing
you.
them today. So, hi, guys. Thank you. I'm so sorry I can't be the whole evening with you, but I will try to catch up with something at least. Hi, Lynn.
Yeah, it's
That's okay.
good to see you. I
Yay.
haven't seen you
Good to
for a
see
long
you.
time.
Yeah. Yeah, it's been a while. So, I wouldn't interrupt more. Yeah, thanks for invitation.
Yes, you bet. So, anyway, I just wanted to let you know, for those of you, a few of you were at the information session last night. So I apologize if I repeat some stuff tonight. It is just because we have different students tonight, okay, than we had last night. So there will be some repetition, which is like my introduction. So I'm going to repeat my introduction. I've been working at Pericles Center for International Legal Education for since 2015 as legal director or legal writing director. I teach legal writing is my big thing, and I teach other skills such as legal English. I've taught Approaching Legal English, Language of Contracts, some of our other courses. I know a little bit about legal writing. And before I became a legal writing director here at Pericles, I was a litigator in the United States. So I was writing a lot. So I was writing all the time, every day at my work, writing different kinds of documents, everything from client letters to memoranda to motions to appellate briefs to whatever. That's the that was the I never thought that would be all I did, but it seemed like that was all I did. And then I saw a client here and there. But most of the time my head was in the computer, right? Writing, researching, and doing that kind of stuff. So I can probably help you with writing, right? At least I've been doing it for, since 2015. And the one thing that you need to know about me is that as a teacher, I write a lot of feedback. So if you take legal writing, You may or may not be surprised by that if you've had another professor that provides a lot of feedback, but most of the students are surprised at the amount of feedback that they get. And that's a good thing. Okay, don't worry about it. I like to write a lot of feedback, and that's because I want you to improve. And I think that you can then come back and look at those documents in a year or in 6 months after the class is over and still use it, right? You can still use that feedback that's in those documents that I gave you. Months and months and months and years probably down the road, you can go back and go, I still have that same problem, right? that feedback in words or in writing is always valuable, that's my opinion on that. Enough about me. I want to do, those of you that were here last night, I did a little quiz. I'm going to do a quiz tonight, but it's going to be a different quiz. But we're using the same program called Minty. So hold on a second. Oh, whoops. I want to go to the... All right. Nope, wrong one. This is the other class I'm teaching tonight after this. We don't want to talk about study skills in here. So you need to go to, hold on. Shahrukh, you can probably put it in the, I thought I had it up and ready to go. But no. It's www.menti.com. All right. So here it is. You'll be able to see it. And you have a code that you input. Once you go to menti.com, there's this little code that you write. And then you can write up to three things. You don't have to write three. Three things. When you hear the words legal writing, what are these things, the first three things that come to mind, or the first thing, if you can't think of three, however many. So please go into Menti and let's throw some ideas up on the screen. So far, I'm not seeing anybody in here with me. I can see down here when people have entered Menti. Once you start writing as well, your comments will come up on the screen. Memos, lots of fun stuff here. All right. Memos, contracts, special vocabulary, special terms, legalese. Very good. Collocations. Legal terminology. Wow, so far nobody's repeating. Outlines. Grammar. Judgments. Good. Okay. So when it's bigger, like grammar's bigger, that means more than one person wrote it. Skills necessary for work. Active verbs. I like that. No passive voice, education, claims, terms of art, law degree, judgments. Okay, we've got eight of you. How many are there tonight, Shahrukh? I can't hear you. I can see your mouth.
Well, I count around 20 participants.
Okay, so we've got eight in here. Minus Donald, minus you, minus me. That's probably about 17.
19, 18, yeah.
Yeah. Iraq. Good. Gosh, you guys, shall or will? Evaluation. You guys are coming up with a lot of good stuff here. Law degree. Okay. All right. Good. So, you know, as we're getting, I'll talk as this is updating, because we're going to keep getting more people updating as I'm talking. So another thing that I want to know is if any, I know some of you, since you were in my class last night, answered this question. And I want to use the little reactions. There's a bar down at the bottom of your screen that's called reactions. And I want you to either, like, you know, put a hand up or a thumbs up to answer this question. Shahrukh has a reaction, or heart, that works. So my question is, has anyone taken a class online? So use the reaction to. Okay. Not very many. Oh, Stanislav, I like. Okay. So not very many of you, but Daria, you should have yours on. She must have walked away from her computer, because she should have hers on. She took legal English with me last semester, so she's definitely taken a class online. All right. So those of you that have taken a class online, have you used Zoom before? Were you using Zoom, this platform that we're using right now? Just put, use a reaction, and that'll tell me. If you show a reaction, then I'm going to assume Zoom. Yeah. Okay. All righty.
I noticed that some of our participants in the participants list, they are using this other emotional kind of characters, and they just basically, some of them just showed
in the chat.
Yes, in the chat.
Yes. Okay. Yeah, because there. There's also in the chat, and I forget about that. there is down at the bottom. You can do it in the chat. You can do it. There's the reactions tab. So Zoom makes it kind of easy to react, I guess, or to say, "Hey, I'm here," and that's good. I've been teaching in Zoom obviously since March, but before that, Shahrukh and I did a pilot project the summer before it, which kind of helped us get into Zoom. Since I've been teaching in Zoom, I really like it because I get to connect with students from all over, right? I'm not just connecting with students in Moscow. So it's quite fun to me on that respect. So in legal writing, all of those things that you guys had on the screen, and I just took it down. I don't know why I did that, but hold on, let me share the screen again. All of these things are very relevant to legal writing, right? We're going to be talking about absolutely, I think, every single one of these things if you take this class, right? At some point, all of this will come up. I like the no passive voice. Whoever wrote that will get an A from me. I'm kidding. But if you don't use passive voice, you'll make me happy. Because that's usually one of the hardest things, or that's one of them. There's a couple of them. One of the hardest things to train Russian students is the passive voice. So when I teach online like this, I use everything that I can, okay? So that means we'll be, thanks, Christina. We'll be using all of the tools that we can, okay? So we just use the Menti. Sometimes I use this. I haven't used it too much in legal writing, but you could see it again because I am constantly updating my lessons. Chat and reactions are really good things. The chat helps me know if there's a connection problem with you or with me. However, if there's a connection problem with me, you probably want to just turn on your mic and tell me. Okay, so if you can't hear me, or if I'm disappearing or something like that, it's probably may mean my Zoom is crashing, and that does happen from time to time. I think it's happened twice since March, which is not, you know, good statistics, because I teach four nights a week, so that's pretty good. I share screens right now. I'm sharing my screen with you, and I share that a lot. I actually use that one all the time. And this is something that you can do as well. If you guys, if I send you to a room, you can share screens in the room. If you want to meet with another student to talk about something, right? You can share screens. This is it's a wonderful thing. You can use the whiteboard, or let's see, where is my whiteboard? Which is, it says annotate. So let's see. So I can use my little, oh, come on. Oh, that's right. I have to stop the screen share and hold on. Now I've lost it. There we go. So if you go into screen share, then you have your whiteboard. And here's where you can draw. You know, you can draw. You guys can write on my screen. So if there's somebody's asking a question about a sentence, which happens a lot in legal writing, and how to fix it, or if there's another way to fix it, you guys can come on this screen and annotate too. You can, you know, you can take the cursor away from me and start writing text or drawing or whatever, erasing things. And that's useful tool. You can do that on your own, right? So we do use this function in legal writing as well. Yes, Shahrukh is going to show you here for a moment. So Shahrukh is drawing on my screen. Maybe. but one of the really cool things in legal writing is that we try to fix your writing. So that means we are going to be using things, tools like this, where we have a document on the screen, and whether that's a whiteboard like this, whether that's a Microsoft Word doc, or whether it's a Google Doc, because it could be any one of those things. I use all of them to share and change and annotate information on the screen. So it's, you know, Zoom gives us that option, and it's a little bit different than in a classroom. We also have these, the one of the really cool parts is the video, all right? So if you miss class, legal writing, if you miss class, it's kind of a big deal. You probably want to watch it, all right? Because we do a lot in every class. And you're going to miss class. And when you miss class, if you miss a lot of classes, then you're going to want to watch those videos. So this is one of the really important tools of Zoom that you should use. It also is really useful if you get comments back from me and you don't quite understand them, or maybe I say, go back and rewatch the recording. Or in this class, or something like that. You have that to go back to it's always there. I mean, maybe in a couple of years, it'll be gone, but as long as you're taking the class and for a year after, it's gonna be there. And then the last really fun tool, my favorite tool probably, well, no, screen sharing is my favorite, but my last fun tool that I like is the breakout rooms, where I send you to a room to discuss something. So tonight, I want to send you to a room, which means I need to know that you're here. which means if you you need either need to have your video on so I can see you, so I can put you in a breakout room, or at least use a reaction and tell me that you're here by putting a heart or you know, a sad crying face or something like that up there. Then I know you're in the room and I can put you in a breakout room. Otherwise, I will put you somewhere separately. Okay. Okay, so some of these, all right, we have a question. Hold on, let me get this. I'm gonna share my screen so you can see the question. All right, there's your question. It's not a really hard one, but you should have something to talk about. All right, so in your opinion, what is the key to good writing? And it's very broad. Good writing. It's not even good legal writing, just good writing, okay? I made it very broad for you guys so that if somebody in the class is not writing as a lawyer, they're not doing legal writing, if they're, because there might be somebody here, then at least you'd have something to talk about. All right, we have, okay, let me create four rooms. Give me one moment while I assign people to rooms. Okay. Just see. And okay. So Almaz, you're here. Okay, good. Daria, Tri. Stanislav. Okay, here we go. Evgeny. Okay, and then here's the last group. Okay, so your rooms are open. I will give you 5 minutes, okay? Any questions before I hit the button? Because once I hit the button, then you will get a notice on your screen saying to join. I think Vaiti or Vaiti v komnate or something like
that. I just noticed that we've got Olga Kavchuk just joining us. So maybe just quickly repeat the task.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I don't see her in here, but I'll once I open the rooms, then I'll put her in a room. So Olga, are you here?
Yeah, I'm here. I need to.
Okay. Okay. So what you're going to be doing is you are going into a room with some other people to discuss a question, and that's the question is, what in your opinion is the key to good writing? Okay.
The language is English.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. English.
Please speak English. But if you have to explain it in Russian, I'm not opposed to that. It's up to you. If you can't express it in English, that's fine. Any questions? All right, here we go. And Olga, I will add you in a moment. I don't see her. There we go. My timer.
In the room four, we've got two persons hasn't joined. Only Ekaterina Stepanova is there.
Okay.
So probably I need to know that Elena, Christina and Elena Shigidina, yeah, both of them. Elena, you need to just to click the button, join the room, and Christina as well, if you wish to be in that room
yeah.
as well.
Christine, can we participate without joining the room? I'm having dinner.
Almas, could you please click on this, accept the, how it usually like this?
Yeah, there should be a
pop-up window.
Something that comes up on your screen here somewhere.
I'm sorry, I was alone in my room and I go out from room.
Yeah, I'll put you in a different room. There you go.
Thank you.
Almas, can you hear me? Almas?
Are you having?
Hello?
Yes, I hear you.
Did you see the pop-up window? There should be like window like this, like pop-up.
On the side somewhere.
Maybe you will transfer them into the you know, existing like one to second or first room. No.
Yeah. I saw it, but now.
Now it's gone.
There isn't.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, sometimes that happens if you don't click on it right away. And there's nothing I can't resend it.
Ah, you can resend. Can you move them into another room?
No? It won't matter.
Okay.
Thanks, Christina. Perfect. I'm gonna go
I noticed that Christina went into the room and she was alone. So I took my managerial decision and tried to transfer her into another room.
Yeah, well, she mentioned she was going to just eat dinner and
okay.
And not go in a room, but
that's even better, probably.
Sorry.
So I didn't think.
I was worried, like that you will be alone in the room.
That's okay. I have the answer, but I just didn't manage to understand how the breaking room is working because I don't use that. But yeah, once the guys will come back, then we can just. I will listen to you because that's the aim of my participation today. I can see three students of mine here. So, and I just want to be sure that maybe some of other students of mine will join us today. So, yeah. And I have a lesson just in 15 minutes. So that's why I will ask them tomorrow what you guys have been doing. So yeah, I will know everything for sure. Good to see you. That's a very cool tool that Pericles is doing these live sessions. I didn't expect this to be so interactive, you know.
Yes, they are.
I suppose it would be kind of a lecture, so that's why I'm just like, oh my gosh, I need to show my face. Oh, I'm eating my borscht now, so possibly not the best solution.
Yep. All right. So I want to hear what you guys talked about. Who wants to start? Otherwise, if somebody doesn't start talking, I will call on you. I'm really good at that.
All right. I can start. Maybe someone will support you. So we unanimously decided that it is important to be a literate person for good writing.
Mm-hmm.
And accurate person. So you should mean what you should write what you mean. No ambiguity. So that these two, accurate and literate, these are two of the most important qualities for good writing. Not only legal writing, but for generally in writing.
Writing. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay.
Maybe someone wants to continue.
Who else? I'm not sure who was in Evgeny's group.
I could continue in our breakout mm-hmm. session. We have determined that clarity is important, and not only the clarity of the person who's actually it's about the person who's writing, because the reader should understand what the author of any document or text wanted to actually say, because mm-hmm. there can be plenty beautiful words, but no one can understand actually the meaning. And we believe it's important to convey all your ideas in a way that can be understood in a single way, so that there won't be like each reader has their own opinion and just all these problems caused by this.
Yes, Regan. Mm-hmm. Who else would like to share? Anna Karpova.
Yes, we discussed in our small group about the logic of the writing, because I think it is the key of good skill of writing. For example, the speech on the paper should be logical, mm-hmm. And people should understand you. What would you like to say in your sentences, as in writing?
Yeah, very good logic.
And of course, the grammar, the right order of the words. I think it's the key too.
Very good. I expect grammar to be the first thing from Russian.
Yeah, of course.
All right. Anybody who else wants to add?
It is not my idea, but nevertheless, we discussed that it is necessary for legal for any writing to have some structure or a plan.
Mm-hmm. Very good. Very good. Yeah. Maxime?
That's all. Well, it seems like many of the participants have the same ideas. So in our group, we had in mind cohesion, expertise on the topic, vocabulary, and that the writer should keep the reader in mind.
Mm-hmm. It's very important. Mm-hmm. And then...
I can add that we need to have a clear understanding of topic and terms and conditions, because usually, mm-hmm. not often, but usually people don't understand the topic, what they should write in general.
Yeah, understanding your topic is really important. And where you're going, right? It's really important. And Natalia, did you want to say something?
Yeah, I want to add something about key points that we didn't agree in our group. We discussed whether plain language means a primitive language, and I really don't believe that it's they are synonyms. Plain and primitive, because good writing means that author thinks about his audience and his reader, and if text is ambiguous and too complicated, that means that we can't reach our goals that we which we had when we was writing this text. So I believe that plain language help us to show some thoughts of us, and it's a key point for a good writing. Not only in general good writing, but for legal writing too.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, thank you very much.
Can I add a couple of words? We were in the same group. Yeah, I didn't have enough time to express my opinion. The thing is, I mean, plain language is good, but there is a big danger to become primitive language. And I can see it in Russian language, when Russian lawyers, you know, they use some English words and transform it in Russian, like they say, you know, like, to make a draft of contract, they say drafted, you know, like for instance. Oh, I mean, we can't.
Well, that's a stylistical choice.
Something informal draft.
That's not good for an email or for a formal email, I mean. And sometimes in your writing, you do need ambiguity. You said that
sometimes
ambiguous, but sometimes you do need it.
Sometimes there are moments where passive voice and ambiguity is okay.
Not permanently.
Right.
Yeah, it should be functional. It should be functional, and you should know what your goal is.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, when it's necessary and you can't avoid it, then when this is one point which you should use it, of course.
Lovely.
I would like to add that the discussion started with my expression that a person who writes something must be something like well-read. He must have read a lot of literature. So he must know the language, have a lot of expressions learned. So that's what I meant.
Well, that's a bonus.
Yeah, and what happens is when you know the meaning of the word in English or in Russian, but you can't find the word in other language, yeah? Like, you know the meaning of in English, but you can't translate it in Russian, and vice versa, that adds words.
That happens.
Or, for example, you can find the word it goes for, точnее, with, sorry.
Yeah. These are all really good things, right? Writing and learning to write well is an art on its own. And you guys have come up with a great list, and I can hear some of Kristina Goncharova, some of her stuff from when she was my student. I can hear some of that in since some of you are her students. I can probably pick out which ones those are. So yay. What the goal of this course, or the whole goal, is to get you to write better, right? You're not gonna walk out of legal writing just like a native speaker, but at the end of legal writing, you will be better than you are right now, guaranteed. And you'll be closer to a native speaker than you are right now. You will have a whole bunch of tools that I will teach you during the semester that we will talk about during our 12 weeks together, so that you can write better and that you can write more like a native speaker. And you will get better as you continue to practice and practice and practice and practice and practice. You will, I can't promise a native speaker, but you'll do better. You'll be able to understand when to use passive voice and when not to use passive voice, and how to use it in English, because that is a very difficult topic. So legal writing itself and what we do in class, I just said that we have 12 weeks. We meet one time a week for 2 hours. And the classes are, we're learning new skills almost every class. We're talking about things, we're having discussions about different things, or we're applying skills that we learned in the previous class. Sometimes we're doing that. So it's one of these classes where as I said earlier, if you miss a class, it can be a big deal. Right, it's good to have the video because you can at least watch the video. Because if you miss the class, you can walk into the next class and go, I have no idea what they're doing. that can be, so it's a good thing for me because it means that I know that I have you in my class, you're going to come. Right. And I like that. I like having my students in class. If you have business things that pull you away from here, it can cause, you may not like that so much. All right, so we're going to talk about everything that we just talked about in terms of writing, passive voice, cleaning up your language, how to format things, like which documents require these types of format, or what the structure is, what you need to have in each document. We're going to talk about the parts of a legal document. We're going to talk about how to organize them. Somebody else talked about organizing. So those are at least five things. You know, making a plan so that, you know, it comes, so you start at the top and there's like a little thread that goes all the way through and the reader can follow you, right? Because the whole point of legal writing is to be clear, direct, and concise. Mm-hmm. And so that can be difficult when you're in another language, right? When English is not your native language. So I do my best at trying to get you to change things and to think differently. So not only are you writing and you're trying new skills, but it's going to challenge you to think differently as well. So you have to be prepared for that. All right. So the dates of the courses, we start next Tuesday, January 26th, I believe. Yep. That's on my calendar. And it goes for 12 weeks and ends on April 20th. I believe that's the Tuesday. I looked at it, but if I was looking at the wrong date, I apologize. And as I said, there are 12 classes. They last 2 hours. We have a break in the middle, but that doesn't mean you're not working. In legal writing, you have a final exam, but the final exam is not a final exam that you expect like in a normal, like Russian or any other class. It's a little thing, all right? We have papers almost every week, and those are more or less where your grade's coming from. The final exam is worth only 10% of your grade. So that's 90% of your grade that's coming from other things. So don't just think, I'll get really good grade on the final. Okay, that will not help you. you need to be doing the other writing as well. This, if you want to improve your English, that will be a benefit that you, side benefit of this class, because you will pick up things. But the point of this course is to improve your writing. So I will be doing more talking in this class, and you guys will not talk as much. If you were in a legal English class, then it's the opposite. You guys talk a lot, I talk a little, and that helps you improve your English language. So if you're wanting to improve your language, legal writing, though it will improve your writing, it will improve your language only on the side, like as an extra added bonus, okay? Not as a goal. All right, now I want to take any questions that you may have. I want to give some time for you guys to ask me questions about the course, or either this one, if you want to ask questions about legal English, I teach that one, and I'm happy to take questions about that course if you are having questions.
Question. Will this course be online or offline?
Online.
Online. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Yes. Oh, did I explain it that well?
What types of documents will be studied during the course?
Mm-hmm. Everything. Not everything. We have a lot. We'll be writing different documents. You'll write a professional article. You'll write an email. You'll write a client letter, and you'll write a an office memorandum. Those are your big ones. And then there are, so that's only four, you think, right? But that's not true. I mean, there are some documents like the client letter and the memorandum are actually have three pieces to it. Okay, so you've got three different documents. You have an outline for the both of those, and you have a first draft and then a second draft. So that's six writings. So you may think, oh, well, I only have to write four documents. No, you're writing that you have about, in class 11, I know there is no homework, although you should be writing. So, and there's another class in there that I believe there's no homework, but you should still be writing, right? You should be doing some research and writing back home, even though you don't have to turn anything in. So every other class has an assignment that you have to upload. It's intense, right,
yeah.
Christina?
Are the assignments something like sent to you and corrected?
Yes.
And sent back to us?
Mm-hmm. Yes, via Moodle. We have a Moodle. That you upload them to this course Moodle, and then it's just an online system. You upload it through that system, and then I make my comments and send it back to you through that same system.
Okay, thank you.
Mm-hmm. Other questions?
No questions, seem to be.
Thank you, Christina.
Christina, maybe you will chip in and add your experience of studying legal writing at our school, many years ago. And how did that kind of, how you managed to use those skills, and are you using still? Or maybe you just, don't need them at all.
So, yeah, Shakrug, thanks. As I said to Lynn in direct messages, I told her that her comments made my eyes made me cry out my eyes while I was studying at Pericles. But this experience definitely was worth it, because and you mentioned only six assignments, I guess, which are legal assignments, but we have. Obviously, we've done much more. I mean, during the course, I remember that there was an assignment to write an instruction on how to make tea, and I thought at that time that I know how to make tea. But after I've received all the comments from Lynn, I've understood. Like, okay. You told us that we need to boil water, but what does boiling mean? Or something like that. And I thought, oh my gosh, the logic behind it is brilliant, because sometimes as a lawyer, you think that something is obvious, but it's not obvious for your reader who hasn't such experience, which means that you have to explain everything and you should be very precise and go step by step in explaining some ideas. So, I mean, there are really a lot of assignments, guys, and I spent nights doing them, but it was worth it. Yeah, that was great. Thanks, guys. And I'll have to leave in 7 minutes, but I'm really interested in listening to you, and I will try to get some feedback from my students to know what you've been talking about here.
Mm-hmm. Right?
Mm-hmm. Thanks.
Thank you. So I got an email from another student, because we just finished the semester, saying pretty much the same thing, that she got my comments from her professional article that she did, and she was it was really disappointing to her, so it's not a surprise. Like, everybody has the same moment. Where they're disappointed by their efforts. They thought that they did better than they put all their all into it, and they get my comments back and they go, I'm an awful writer. And I try to prepare students for that. And I try to prepare you for all of this, but it never works. I never end up being able to prepare you. I had one student tell me was my student a year and a half ago, told me that she would get a chocolate bar and a glass of wine and turn on some nice music, and then she would read my comments. She had a whole routine because it would put her in a better mood.
That doesn't sound so bad. Didn't need a glass of whiskey or something.
No, she didn't drink a whole, I said a glass of wine, not a bottle. But she had a routine of how she had figured out how to make it easier to read my assignments. Or read her assignment, my comments on her assignment. So it's not that I'm being mean or I'm trying to, you know, I'm not. I don't think I'm mean in my comments. It's just that they, it hurts when you see them and you want to see like a 5, right? You got an A on it and that's not what you got. So usually you guys don't know what grade you have. You have absolutely no idea. You have there's points on every assignment, but you have no idea what the other students are doing. So you don't know in relation to the other students if that grade is a good grade or a bad grade, or you have no idea. I do. I know where you're at. So that's okay. And that's perfectly okay. Your job is to just write better than you did on the previous assignment. And to do better than you did. Your job is not to compete against your fellow students, but to compete against yourself and improving you, right? And so if you keep your focus there on you, then it doesn't matter what the other students are doing. Because my comments are focused on you 100% and your writing. And what the other students are doing doesn't, granted, I have to give you a grade, taking into account the other students, but the comments that I give you are based on your writing and nobody else's. So. But they do, they are worth it. They do help. I hate it that people cry, but I'm not trying to make you cry. I don't want to make you cry. It hurts my heart, but I do know it happens. So, and I've been there. Let me tell you, I have been there. I have been in your position where I have looked at my paper and my professor has like turned it into a mess, you know, and I just want to cry as well. And I did, and that's okay. I cried and then I got back up. Then I woke up the next day and I started working on how to fix it. Right, that's what we do. Any other questions? I'm not trying to prosecute you guys though, no. I'm defending you. I was a defense attorney as well, I've done both. I would say I want to defend you more than prosecute you.
I think everything is clear. Thank you.
Okay. All right. Thank you, Anastasia. All right. Well, if there are no other questions, then we can end the session. And